Children, in our previous class, we have completed our lesson 5, the magpie's lesson from the textbook, and also we have completed exercises from the textbook. Today, let's begin our 5th lesson from the activity book. In this lesson, we should read and understand the story which they have given here. Read and understand. Let us read this story, okay? There once lived in a village 6 men who could not see. How many villagers lived there? 6 men. One day, an elephant came to their village. Which animal came to their village? Elephant. The 6 men did not know anything about elephants, because they could not see, right? So, the 6 men did not know anything about the elephants. Let us go and touch the elephant. Our hands will tell us what the elephant looks like. So what they have decided? They have decided to touch the elephant with their hands to know about the elephant, how it looks like. One suggested from the 6. So the 6 men went and touched the elephant. What they did? They went to the elephant and touched it. The elephant is like a pillar, said the man who touched its leg. Who touched its leg? He said, like, it's like a pillar. It is like a rope, said the second. Who touched its tail? Who touched its tail? It's like a rope, he said. The elephant is like the branch of a tree, said the third man. He had touched its trunk. Who touched the trunk? What he said? The elephant is like the branch of a tree. And the fourth man touched its ear and said, it is like a big hand fan. Who touched its ear? He said, it's look like a big hand fan. The elephant is like a wall, said the fifth man. Who touched its stomach? The man told that the elephant looks like a wall. It is like a solid pipe, said the sixth one, because he touched its tusk. So they began to quarrel about what the elephant looked like. So see, they have touched the several parts and they have said their opinion, and they began to quarrel themselves. An elderly man who was passing by overheard their argument. He explained, each of you is right, but only if you put all your knowledge together will you know what an elephant really looks like. What he said, if they are together, they can easily reveal how the elephant looks like, because see, ears are like big hand fan and several parts are in several types. So if they put together, they really will know about how the elephant looks like. Okay, this is our story. Now let us get into the exercise. Okay, children, in this exercise we should tick the correct answers from the options. See here, let us check the first one. How many men who could not see lived in the village? In the first line only it is there. There once lived in a village 6 men who could not see. So how many in the options, which one we have to take? Of course, 6. Let us tick option C. Now, let us check the second one. Which animal came to the village? A cow, an elephant, a dog. Which animal came? Of course, an elephant. So, let us tick the option B. The 6 men wanted to touch the elephant because they have given again 3 options. Liked elephants, liked to argue, or wanted to know what an elephant look like. Of course, they want to check how it look like. So option C we have to tick. Let us check the last one. Each of the men had a different idea about what an elephant look like, because they were foolish, it was very big, each of them touched different parts of it. Which is the correct answer here? Of course, each of them touched different parts of it. So we have to tick option C. Let us check the next exercise. Let us get into our next exercise. Write true or false. Let us read this sentences first. The six men did not know anything about elephants. Is it true or false, children? Of course, they do not know because they could not see, right? So, this statement is correct. So, let us write here true. Let us check the next one. The first man thought that the elephant was like a pillar. Is it true or false? Yes, true. Let us check the next one. The third man thought that the elephant was like a rope. No, false, because the third person touched the elephant's trunk and he said that it's like a branch. So it is false. Let us check the next one. The six men agreed on what the elephant really looked like. No, they completely argued themselves. So it is false. Let us write false here. And let us check the next one. The elderly man told them that each of them was right. Is it true or false? Of course, true. Let us write true here. Now, let us get into our next exercise. Word wise. Many expressions use comparisons with animals to describe humans' qualities. For example, she fought like a tiger, or he was as gentle as a lamb. Fill in the blanks with the correct words from the brackets to complete these expressions. Some of the human qualities will describe with the comparison of animals. So let us try. See here, as timid as a duck, snake or mouse. Can you say, children? Of course, as timid as a mouse. So let us write here mouse. And let us check the next one. As wise as an otter, owl, ostrich. It is the correct answer here. Of course, owl. As wise as an owl. And let us check the next one. As brave as a lion, crow, kangaroo. Which is the correct answer here? Of course, lion is a brave animal. So we can write here lion. Let us check the fourth one. As sly as a fox, wolf, ferret. Which is the correct answer here? Of course, fox. As sly as a fox. And let us check the fifth one. As busy as a butterfly, moth, bee. Which is the correct answer here? Of course, bee. Because it is very busy to collect the honey, right? So, let us check the next one. As stubborn as a horse, cow, mule. Which will be stubborn? Of course, mule. Let us write mule here. And let us check the next one. As free as a cat, dog, bird. Which will be the free? Of course, as free as a bird. So, let us write the word bird here. Let us check the next one. As proud as a cheetah, peacock, parrot. Which is the proud creature from this? Of course, as proud as peacock. Let us write the word peacock here. Let us check the next one. As greedy as a pig, donkey, monkey. Which is the greedy animal from the options? Tell me, children. Of course, pig. Pig is a greedy animal. Let us check the next one. As slippery as a or an monkey, mouse, eel. Which is the slippery? Of course, eel. So let us write the answer eel. Okay, children, we have completed this exercise from the word wise. Let us get into our next exercise to find the common names of 10 birds in the word search. In this exercise, you have to find the common names of 10 birds in this word search. Write them in the blanks. For example, they have given one bird name here, sparrow. They have circled, written in the blank. In the same manner, please find out remaining 9 bird names and please write them in the blanks. Okay, children, this is your homework. Children, our next exercise is spell write. we should circle the correctly spelled word in each set. See, these are sounds like very similar. We should circle the correctly spelled word in each set. Here, the word is cheetah, but they have given similar words over here. We should select the correct word from the set. Okay, are you ready, children? Our first word is cheetah. And which is the correct word from the set? Can you guess? Can you spell the word cheetah? Of course, C-H-E-E-T-A-H. It is the correct word. So let us circle it. And our next word is leopard. But they have given again a set of words. So which is the correct word from this set? Can you spell the word leopard? Of course, L-E-O-P-A-R-D. So let us circle it. So let us check the next one. Habitat. Which is the correct answer from the set? Can you spell the word habitat? Of course, we can spell the word like H-A-B-I-T-A-T. So let us circle the word habitat. Our next word is project. Can you spell the word project? P-R-O-J-E-C-T, project. So let us circle the correct word from the set. And our next word is prey. Which is the correct answer from this set? P-R-E-Y, prey. So we have circled here. Okay children, today we have completed few exercises from the lesson 5 from the activity book. So let us meet in our next class. Let's continue remaining exercises. Okay children, thank you.